The Seahawks. They run. They pass. They tackle. And now,
we've got the others on the run.
They sing in the Seahawks Locker Room Rock, the team's first ever music video in stereo and on sale now at only $15 at all area Magnolia Hi-Fi and video outlets. And this souvenir poster is just $5. Proceeds benefit Project SOS. The offer is limited, so hurry, because the blue wave is on a roll.
The last of the summer season's big crop of movies opens today. The Return of the Living Dead, American Flyers, Year of the Dragon, Volunteers, and The Bride. Entertainment Tonight surveyed several hundred people on the want-to-see potential for two of the new movies opening today. Any film scoring over 100 stands a chance for a good opening weekend box office. They won't have to draft anyone to see Volunteers. It scored 124 and shapes up to be the last strong summer box office movie despite mediocre reviews. However, the news is not so good for The Bride. There won't be many people walking down the aisles. The Bride scored a want-to-see of only 51. It'll be a brief honeymoon.
Can the craft of filmmaking outweigh the content of a film? Leonard Maltin answers that question in his review of Michael Cimino's first film since his disastrous Heaven's Gate 5 years ago.
There are two ways to look at a movie, emotionally and intellectually. A really great movie grabs you on both levels. Now, I don't think Michael Cimino's Year of the Dragon is a great movie, but it sure got to me on a gut level. I was riveted to the screen. This is the story of a cop who's obsessed with breaking the chain of corruption in New York's Chinatown.
You think gambling, extortion, corruption are kosher? Because it's 1,000 years old? This is America you're living in, and it's 200 years old, so you better get your clocks fixed. You're not special, and you're not beyond the law any more than the Puerto Ricans or the Polacks.
Mickey Rourke is obsessed, and he draws other characters into his madness, including a TV reporter to whom he's attracted, and the young czar of Chinatown, played by John Lone. But the source of Rourke's obsession lies far from Chinatown.
You're fighting the whole world all the time. I'm sick and tired of Vietnam as an excuse for everything you guys do.
Remember, it was Michael Cimino who painted that picture of Vietnam as living hell in The Deer Hunter. Well, this film is a continuation of the same story. Only the setting has changed. It has the same violence, the same intensity, and I had the same knots in my stomach. But then it just gets out of hand. The violence escalates, and so does the unbelievability. When it's all over, I don't know what point it was trying to make. And yet, as sheer movie making, I found it electrifying. So, if you're curious, adventurous, and have a strong stomach, I recommend Year of the Dragon. I didn't always like it, but I did find it fascinating. So I'm going to give it a 7. I'm Leonard Maltin, Entertainment Tonight.
And before you head out to see a summer movie this weekend, here's a look at how Leonard rated some of the other films playing in movie houses around the country.